Guten Morgen, alle Guten. Ich bin dann der Prof von Luxemburgisch with Anne. Und hier ist die neue Lektion. And here is your new lesson. This lesson is all about two adverbs, which are quite close in meaning and they are often translated by only. But you should not always translate these two adverbs by only. I am talking about erreicht. Now listen and repeat after me for the correct pronunciation. Erreicht. And the other one is nimmen. Nimmen. Now, are you ready? Bist du bereit? Dann los! Start immediately with an example. I can tell you, mir hun erreicht ekant. And I can tell you, mir hun nimmen ekant. What is the difference? Well, if I tell you, mir hun erreicht ekant, you can hear that I expect to have more children. That at the moment I have only one child, but there will come some more children later on. And if I tell you, ich schon nimmen ekant, this means I have just one child and I don't expect to have some more. Okay? So let's start with erreicht. Erreicht. Erreicht, yes, can be translated by only, but more in the sense of not before or no more than. Let's have some examples. Beispiele. Mein Mann könnt erreicht samstags heim. Mein Mann könnt erreicht samstags heim. So this means that my husband will not come home before Saturday. Okay? Or I can say, ich schon erreicht 5 Seiten am Buch gelies. Then I understand that I haven't read more than 5 pages so far, but I will read some more later on. Okay? But the best way to explain the word erreicht is to consider it as the opposite of already, which is in Luxembourgish schon. Great. Let's have some examples with schon. Oh, wart, das schon 10 Uhr. Oh, warst du schon 10 Mal zu Paris? The first sentence expresses that we thought it to be earlier. And the second sentence expresses that I consider 10 times quite a lot. And erreicht is the exact opposite. For example, I can say, wart, das erreicht 10 Uhr. Oh, ich war erreicht 2 Mal zu Paris. So here the first sentence expresses that I thought it to be later, and the second sentence tells me that I consider 2 times not much, but there will come some more later on. Okay? As you can see, erreicht has the notion of an ongoing process, a notion of time. And this is very important to keep in mind whenever you want to translate the English word only. For example, I could tell you, I have spent only 10 euros so far. Now, here the correct translation would be, ich schon erreicht 10 Euro ausgehen. Okay, so I have spent 10 euros so far, but I will spend some more later on. There is a notion of time, there is a process in this. Because if you just tell, if you tell, or if you translate this sentence, ich schon nimmen 10 Euro ausgehen, that means that you have spent 10 euros and that you won't spend more money. Have you heard the difference? Great. Let's have a last example with erreicht. Der Konzert hat erreicht 9 Uhr angefangen. So the concert was expected to start earlier, but it only starts at 9 o'clock. So it didn't start before 9 o'clock. Again, a notion of time. Now let's have a look at the word nehmen. By contrast, nemen means only, and a synonym is just. And in Luxembourgish, this is just. So you can either use just or nemen. Now, nemen expresses the fact that something is considered as not a lot, or it can be a quantity or an action that isn't expected to change. Beispiel, example. Ich esse sonde sowas nemen ein Zopp. So this means that I just eat this soup. Okay, ich esse nemen ein Zopp. And this is a routine and this isn't expected to change. Or I can tell you, hat bleibt nemen ein Stund. So she will stay only 1 hour, okay? So, and this is considered as not a lot if I tell you, hat bleibt nemen ein Stund, okay? Or I can tell you, ich sin mit, ich lesen nemen 5 Seiten. Ich lese nemen 5 Seiten. This means that I will read only 5 pages. There will come no more pages today because I am tired. Have you now understood a little bit the difference between erreicht and nemen? So erreicht has always this notion of an ongoing process, a notion of time, that something will come later on, something will follow. Exercise, Übung. Now I will tell you 3 sentences and you will have to find out which is the correct adverb to use. Should you use erreicht or nemen? And if you want to practice more because you think you have still some difficulties, you can head over to my blog and under this lesson, you will find a larger exercise with 10 or 12 sentences with the solution. And you can download the whole transcript of this lesson so to practice and to memorize it better. Warst du bereit? Are you ready? Dann los. Satz Nummer 1. Ich schon 20 Euro dabei. Hopefully you've got ich schon nehmen 20 Euro dabei. This is considered as not a lot and it will not change for the moment. Gut. Satz Nummer 2. Ich komme um 7 Uhr hin. In the sense of not before then. Hopefully you've got ich komme erreicht um 7 Uhr hin. So then you can understand that I will not come home before 7 o'clock. Dann heißt der letzte Satz. Das 9:30. Hopefully you've got das reicht 9:30. Or you can say das reicht 9:30. Sometimes we just skip the first E and instead of saying erreicht, we say reicht. Das reicht 9:30. Now I hope that this lesson was helpful and don't forget to head over to my blog to find out many more lessons. Merci fürs Zuschauen. Thank you for watching. Adi!